This one might be a bit distasteful to some of you, but hear us out, because despite sounding like a cooking method, boil in the bag is a new type of environmentally friendly cremation that's becoming available in the United Kingdom. Here to explain this water funeral is Professor Douglas Davies, Director of Life and Death Studies, all the way from Durham University. Good morning, Professor Davies. I guess you better explain to us, what is this? I'm really reluctant to say it again, but boil in the bag method.
Yes, Anna, I rather dislike that phrase, if I'm absolutely honest about it, because I think it's rather disrespectful to those people who will choose this option in the future. It is quite simply a process whereby a human body is placed into a container, into a machine, really, a finely engineered piece of equipment, which is filled then with water and with alkaline, a little alkaline within it. It's heated and placed under pressure, and over a period of time, 4 hours plus, the human body is reduced to its skeletal remains, which are then taken out rather as a pure white skeleton, really, with the bones very, very fragile. The bones are then reduced to a form of powder, and the relatives get back those remains. One of the trade names for this in the UK is resomation. It's just a word, really. And resumated remains will then go back to the family, who can do with them exactly what they would now do with cremated remains. So it is pressurized alkaline solution, heated over a period of time, and that then reduces all the dissolvable parts of us, if you like, taking us back to our basic elements. I guess many of us are very familiar with that phrase that's been part of funeral services for hundreds of years, when we talk about earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust, which, put it another way, is saying element to element, or elements to elements. And that's what's happening in resumation. It's got lots of different names. The Americans rather like talking about water cremation. Rather strange term, I think, because there's no cremation involved. Or some people speak of aquamation, focusing on the water process of what goes along. But the one trade name in the UK is resumation, with a machine called a resumator, if you like, and maybe that phrase will catch on for the process itself.
So you're obviously an expert and you know quite a lot about it, but when you look at the numbers, it's not actually a very popular method at the moment, even though it's been around for quite a while.
It's not been around at all in the UK yet. It has yet to be introduced this coming late summer, autumn. In America, 10, 12 years, and 27 or more states in the US have legalized it, and it's been in use. One of my research students who did her doctor's degree on resumation, Georgina Robinson, has been off to the States doing field work where this actually happens. So long-standing there, not in the UK yet, but for example, in South Africa, and many people will become familiar with the story that Bishop Desmond Tutu, I guess one of the best known Anglican bishops in the world, went this way himself when he died not so very long ago.
When we look at the numbers, it's about a third. Do you see it growing in popularity on the basis that it is supposed to be gentler on the body and kinder to the environment?
My guess is yes. I've done lots of research on different forms of funerals, including what's often called here woodland burial, natural tree burial, which only started in the UK in 1994-95, and we already have 300 or 400 sites right across the UK. So that lifted off fairly quickly, whereas when cremation was first introduced way back in the 1880s, it took 50 odd years before even 1% of the Brits were cremated, and now 80% of Britons are cremated. I think, given the strength of feeling about ecology, environmentalism, I sometimes like to play with the concept lifestyle and death style. I've got a feeling that people with an environmental lifestyle would opt really for this, for resumation as their death style. There's a coherence about it, really.
Without being too intrusive, Professor Davies, what's your death style?
Well, my death style is something I keep to myself. Why? Because I'm an academic who studies cremation, burial, reusing old graves, and now we have a government grant, actually, for my Centre for Death and Life Studies at Durham University to work with the company introducing this over the next 2 years. So I find it very useful to be academically neutral, but to be as truly descriptive of these processes as I possibly can be.
It's been very insightful. Thank you very much for talking to us this morning, Professor Douglas Davies from Durham University.